Okay, I'm going to explain how I did this because it takes too long to do it and explain it. So it's pretty just basic skills. So what I did was I plumbed these two wires from here and here, black and white, going here in through here and coming to black in here. Left about 7 to 8 inches. Okay. Then the return is red. It goes in here, staple, comes through here, comes up here, goes here, and up to the meters. Okay? And that's the same with both of them. Again, black, coming from the panel, staple, came up, black. This is your line, this is your load, this is going back to the heater. 30 amp breakers. I put the tags on here. What I do is I take the sheeting off and put it back on, because when you have the panel off, you're like, which one is this? So I label them. This is ceiling heat, this is the pump house, this is the pump heat. Those two are existing over there. I moved them over. These are the two that we just put in. I have not turned this on. This is not live yet, because there's no power coming to here. So we got one, two. Then we have two going over here. This is going to the pump. Red one. This one's going to the pump house heat. So this whole panel has to have heat in a pump house. The white wire on here is actually hot. So at the end of the white wires, I tape it black, black, black. Same over here, black, black. These are my loads, so I take the red and the white one red, so they're both hot. So this hooks up to the thermostat, and when the thermostat gets to the temperature you want it, it says, okay, it's time to turn on, boys. And then it goes up to the red. Boom. So anyways, if you see me sitting here doing that, it'd take forever. It took like an hour and a half, 2 hours to put this all in. We had one little mishap to get the pipe connected up here. It was sticking out, and so we had to shim it in this way. Then when we did, my wire clamps right here, we weren't paying attention, and it busted through this piece. Not a big deal. On another video, I'll do a video on how to fix something like this. And I'm going to use 9 or 20 minute mud on here. And that mud is hotter than regular mud. And I'll pack it in there and bubble it up just a little bit, sand it down. You won't even know it's there. Anyways, we'll do that on another video. So there you have it. That's how you wire for ceiling heat 240. I'm going to go ahead and go wire and mount. I already wired it. Go ahead and mount the heater up on the ceiling over there, and then we'll be done. But the only thing left here to do is we got the 100 amp that I put in here. There's going to be a ground that's grounded off onto here that will also be grounded off onto here. Okay? So there'll be 224 gauge coming up through here. It's really thick wire coming in here. Coming down into here and here. Hopefully that makes sense for you. So that way we got huge powers. This, once that goes into here, two legs of power, this whole thing is lit up. Okay? And I gotta just run to the store and grab that 224 gauge wire. It's really thick. Then I'll take a video of me putting that in there, the last thing. If you have any questions, please comment and I'll do my best to help you out. And if it gets too complicated for you, personal message me, and I'll instant message with you if I'm home. But I'd love to help you out. This is pretty simple. So I saved $1,800. By code, I have to have the electrician hook this piece to here. So I'm going to pay him $200 to do that tonight. I saved $1,800 by doing this. You can do this also. Take your time, review my video many times, stop it, pause it, go do what you're doing, come back, review it. If it doesn't explain it enough, comment, instant message me, and I'll help you. Let's go put that other fan on. So I got my wife up there. Hold that down. I'll talk to her here. Hold them down, all of them down, Monica. I need one more arm. I'm using washers and Nylex type bolts. Nuts, sorry. So we installed a heater right up there on the ceiling, and then we also installed one on the other end of the shop in that far corner. So you can do this yourself and save $1,800. Okay, you got a double pole, 220 thermostat, 240. The power coming in. Black, the load going out is the red. Line, that's the power, it's going to be the top, that's the L1 and L2. The load is T1 and T2, that's the red. Get your wire nut. Everybody knows how to put on wire nuts. So basically, we're going to wire the black to the black, and the red to the white, which is also power. I like the wire nuts and wings because they're easier to twist, especially as I get older and I'm not as tall as these young electricians. Now we're going to the load going up to the heaters. That's the red. That's the T on the back of your double pole thermostat. That's the T1. The T2 is the red. We're using the wire, the white wire, as the red. Okay, now I'm going to shut all of it. Walk you through what we did. On full, plugged in, looks good. He put in this wire, and this wire, and this wire for connect. So he took two lines off of here of power. Okay, two power. Come over here, they put one in here, and one in here. Then, this white bus, zoom in here, he connected a line on top of this white bus, and he came in and put one on this bus. Okay, that's your neutral. Then, where did he put the ground? Down here. So, down here, okay, so we put the ground into here, comes up, comes over here, and goes into a ground bus here. The white is on this white terminal, the two blacks. That's all there is. We'll put the panels back on, make it look real pretty. There we go. Okay, let's turn it on and see if it works. Oh yeah, pretty nice. So come on back down here. You can probably hear it. So the correct temperature here right now is about 55. Not like I said, about 50 when I'm not in here. So, like the charmer. Anyways, I hope you like my videos. If you have any questions, make sure you give me a comment. If you have a long question, send me a personal message and I'll help you out. This isn't that difficult. Just follow my steps. If you have to review a video of mine, there's four videos, 1 through 4. As you well know, go back and hey, it really helps me out. Share these with your friends and give me a thumbs up if this really helped you. Thanks. We'll see you on the next video. Okay, got the panels up. Looks good. I just got to do some labeling here on what they are. We got three live circuits and a spare here. Looks good. Okay, I'm going to explain how I did this because it takes too long to do it and explain it. So it's pretty just basic skills. So what I did was I plumbed these two wires from here and here, black and white, going here and through here and coming to black into here. Left about 7-8 inches. Okay? Then the return is red. It goes in here, staple, comes through here, comes up here, goes here, and up to the heaters. Okay? And that's the same with both of them. Again, black, coming from the panel, staple, came up, black. This is your line, this is your load, this is going back to the heater. 30 amp breakers.